Good evening. I want to welcome every one of you to this May 2019 pinning ceremony. Thank you for joining us in this celebration. My name is Belen Kirsten. I am the director of the College of the Sequoias Registered Nursing Program. So before we get started, as a courtesy to those around you, I'd like to ask that all cell phones and pagers or any other electronic devices that you might have be turned off or put on vibrate. We don't want to disrupt this ceremony. The COS Registered Nursing Pinning Ceremony is a symbolic welcoming of the newly graduated nurses into the nursing profession. This registered nursing program is rigorous and challenging. These graduates before us have trained hard, studied diligently, and made great strides to complete their nursing program and participate in tonight's pinning ceremony. Let's give them a round of applause. I'd like to take a moment to thank those who have contributed to the success of these students. The ongoing success of the COS Registered Nursing Program, our COS Board of Trustees, Lori Cardoza, Ken Nunes, Greg Sherman, Raymond Macarino, and John Len. Our superintendent and president, Mr. Brent Calvin. It is through their support and dedication that our registered nursing program continues to graduate students who are very well prepared to serve our community. I also like to thank our healthcare facilities at Venice Health, Kauai Delta Healthcare District, and our healthcare partners in a variety of healthcare settings. Throughout this school, we have organizations in our county and school districts. Your support and contributions have been and continue to be invaluable to us. Our hospital and healthcare agency personnel who have worked with and supported and mentored these graduates, thank you for all that you do. Our COS faculty members who taught and mentored these students, and and in their prerequisite classes, Dr. Thea Trimble, Dr. Heather Moore, and Dr. Linda Flora. Our adjunct faculty who continue to help in meeting the demands of our scheduling needs, we could not do this without you. Our fantastic TV and media service expert, Mr. Patrick Mitchell, Ms. Vanessa Lamb, and Mr. Steve Lamar. The audio visuals for tonight's ceremony are coordinated by Patrick and Vanessa and would not be a success without them. Our Vice President of Academic Services, Dr. Jennifer Vega Lacerna. We appreciate her support. Our Associate Dean of Nursing and Allied Health, Dr. Jonna Shingle. We appreciate her support and guidance. Our staff, Amelia Sweeney, Administrative Assistant to the Director of Nursing, and Angela Sanchez, Administrative Assistant to the Associate Dean. We thank them for their hard work and support. They make our work and division run smoothly. All of us would be lost without their daily help. Ms. Valerie Fisher of Health Workforce Initiative, funded by the California Community Colleges Division of Economic and Workforce Development. And last but certainly not least, I thank the COS Registered Nursing Program faculty. I am very proud to be associated with each one of these dedicated, hardworking, and talented instructors. Please stand for a round of applause. This pinning ceremony is one of the most time-honored traditions in celebrating the completion of a nursing program for the graduates, and it is in its faculty's way of sending them off into their professional careers. This is a gift to the graduates. The tradition of the nursing pin and the pinning ceremony originated in the 1860s at the Nightingale School of Nursing. By 1916, the practice of pinning nursing graduates was standard throughout the United States. Since the earliest days of professional nursing in America, graduate nurses have proudly displayed their pin that represents their individual school of nursing. The nursing pin is a treasured symbol and conveys to other graduates associated with the everlasting bond of their school. The nursing pin is a physical evidence that represents our profession and heritage and is intrinsic to our identity as registered nurses. Our profession of nursing celebrates, rewards, and recognizes the art of caring that is at the heart of all professional nurses. The COS Registered Nursing Program faculty staff welcome each and every one of you to this very special pinning ceremony of the Registered Nursing Class of May 2019. Now I'd like to introduce to you the President and Superintendent of the College of the Sequoias, Mr. Brent Calvin.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the College of the Sequoias. As Ms. Kirsten said, I'm Brent Calvin, and I am thrilled to serve as a superintendent president here at the district. And it's one of my great pleasures to be able to participate in ceremonies just like this one here tonight. You may know this, but the nursing program was started in 1970 to combat a shortage of nurses in our region. And counting the 39 graduates up on stage tonight, the program has graduated 3,201 registered nurses over the last 49 years. Amazing, isn't it? In fact, the healthcare partners that Ms. Kirsten talked about earlier report to us that about two-thirds of all of their registered nurses got their training at the College of the Sequoias, and it really does speak to the strength of those partnerships. We'd like to thank Adventist Health Care Network as well as the Kaweah Delta Healthcare District for their partnership and their support of our program over the years. I'd like to take a moment just to thank our faculty for the wonderful job that they have done and continue to do with our students. I'd like to congratulate our graduates here tonight. We all know how rigorous this program is, and yet they've scaled the wall to get up on this stage. And finally, we'd like to just thank you for your support of these graduates over the last couple of years. This is a very committed, dedicated, and driven group, and they probably would have found a way up on this stage even without our support. But your love and support over the last couple of years has made their path that much smoother. So thank you very much for that. We'd like to thank you for being here and celebrating with us tonight. It promises to be a fun evening, so thank you for being here.
We're going to have our opening class speaker, Christy Hoslem.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Christy Hoslem. Thank you all for coming to celebrate with us and our accomplishment in the completion of the COS nursing program. Prior to entering the program, someone made the statement to me that if it's going to happen, it will happen during nursing school. I came to realize quite soon, actually, that she was speaking the truth. But little did I know, I would experience a new personal trial each semester to come. Every individual sitting here before you on this stage today has gone through not only educational, but personal growth. As we have all experienced our own set of challenges throughout the 2 years that we have been together, one of my great mentors would call these challenges and the growth that precedes it, growing pains. And while those moments have been painful at times, we are here before you, ready to take on the next set of challenges that come our way, because all in all, beauty has risen out of those depths. I would like to share a quote with you by Elizabeth Kubler-Ross, a Swiss-American psychiatrist and author of On Death and Dying. "The most beautiful people we have known are those who have known defeat, known suffering, known struggle, known loss, and have found their way out of the depths. These persons have an appreciation, a sensitivity, and an understanding of life that fills them with compassion, gentleness, and deep loving concern. It has been an honor to be a part of the spring cohort of 2019, because each individual up here seeks to care for those around them. We care about our patients and our loved ones, our instructors and our peers. And while at times it was difficult, we made the choice to come together as a team to care for and provide support for one another and those in distress or need. I'm reminded of an activity one of our clinical instructors had us do. We sat down with a sheet of paper and we wrote down the things that we have to do. At the end, we discussed the things that we felt we had to do. Some of the responses were, I have to do my ATI assignments. I have to do my laundry. I have to clean. I have to pick up the kids. And one of mine was, I have to call my mom. After sharing our haves, our instructor proceeded to tell us, you don't have to do any of that. I sat back pondering on this new idea, and it came to realization that she was absolutely right. The only things that we have to do are eat, drink water, rest, and have warmth in order to survive. And that's according to Maslow's hierarchy of needs, which us nursing students are now very well familiar with. The rest is a choice. I don't have to, but I get to call my mom. I get to care for her, and I get to have moments with her and other people in times that are worth having. Moments that are made by choice. We don't have to do anything. It was our choice to join this program, and it is our choice to get through each trial we have faced along the way. And it is our choice to be sitting here before you today. We get to do this. We get to be RNs. We get to care for those who are in need, to care for those we love, and to care for those who can't care for themselves, or even those who choose not to. We get the opportunity to thank each person who has been there to support us, care for us, and love us. Even in our trying times where we were exhausted and grumpy, because we were sleep deprived, and at times even a bit hangry, which, if you don't already know, means the lack of food we ingested throughout the day caused us to become irritable and a little angry. So we thank you. We thank you to every one of you who have supported and cared for us and loved us. Thank you to all of the instructors for choosing to share your time and efforts with us, and for giving us the opportunity to appreciate all you have taught and done for us. It has been an honor to be a part of this program and an honor to be in the presence of great minds and caring hearts. We would also like to thank Esther of Esther's Palace for doing the decorations that we have up here today. Thank you, everyone.
Mama said, burn your biographies, rewrite your history, light up your wildest. dreams, museum victories. Every day we wanted everything, Mama said, don't give up, it's a little complicated. All tied up, no more love, and I'd hate to see you waiting.
To be a valedictorian or a salutatorian of a nursing class is an amazing achievement. Competition is tough and demanding. We acknowledge the status of our valedictorian and salutatorian tonight by having them lead their fellow students into the ceremony, each holding the classic lamp of learning. The lamp is the traditional symbol of light of illumination, enlightenment, and knowledge. The symbol of the lamp of knowledge is part of where we get the phrase, burning the midnight oil, in reference to studying late. something these nursing graduates know well. We also acknowledge our valedictorian salutatorian with a special ribbon to recognize their accomplishment. Tonight, we recognize two of our students. The student with the highest GPA of the May 2019 class, the valedictorian is Natalie Ramirez. I just want to make sure I'm giving you the right one. Congratulations.
Go, Natalie!
The student with the second highest GPA of the May 2019 class, salutatorian, is Jamie Rodriguez. As each of you prepares to enter the most wonderful, dynamic, challenging, and most excellent profession of registered nursing, we leave you with some final thoughts. Practice your profession with skill, safety, diligence, joy, caring, and most importantly, with the highest degree of integrity. Be an advocate for your patients. Be kind and considerate to the families and loved ones, and have a sense of reverence and pride in your work. Be confident that you have received a solid basic nursing education. But in nursing, learning never stops. Commit yourself to being a lifelong learner and to contribute to your profession by mentoring others. Take pride in being a College of the Sequoias graduate, as the faculty and staff take pride in you. The rich and varied world of nursing awaits you. My congratulations to each of you and best wishes for a wonderful career. Mr. Calvin, the students before you have met all the requirements of the College of the Sequoias Division of Nursing and Health and Allied Health and the California Board of Registered Nursing and are now qualified to sit for the Registered Nursing Licensure Examination. I now present to you the College of the Sequoias Associate Degree Registered Nursing Program graduating class of May 2019. We will now present the diplomas and pins. Natalie Ramirez. Jamie Rodriguez. Carly Anderson. Stacy Apostle.
Yeah, go Stacy!
I know her.
Alejandra Berrigan. Mary Elizabeth Brown. Heather Kabu Tutan. Yeah. Dorian Cavasso. Zahara Chekabob. Myra Diaz. Dana Emmerich. Jasmine Espinosa. Julie Estrada. Paige Ferreira. Antoinette Flores. David Guzman.
Smile, David.
Christy Haslam. Delaney Howerton.
Washington.
We will.
Farah Khan. Alfredo Lopez. Pasal Lohr. Ravinder Mann.
Love you.
Brooke Maddock. Kristen Miller.
Best wife ever!
Billy Moa.
Danielle Navaretti. Tanya Nicholas.
Yeah, baby!
Michelle Oakham. Norma Pellison.
You did it, best friend. I love you.
Love you.
Laura Romo.
Way to go, beautiful!
Yeah. Krista Sanchez. Miguel Santana. Manjinder Singh.
Go, Lottie. Go, Manjinder.
Vicente Tinoco. Brahan Sahaya. Mercedes Velasquez. Daniel Watson.
That's my husband.
Hong Yang. So now I'd like to invite all the registered nurses in the audience to join the graduates by saying the International Nurses Pledge. It's in the back of your little program. Okay, here we go. In full knowledge of the obligations I am undertaking, I promise to care for the sick with all the skill and the understanding I possess, without regard to race, creed, color, politics, or social status, sparing no effort to preserve quality of life alleviate suffering, and to promote health as affirmed by the person. I will respect at all times the dignity and beliefs of the patient under my care, holding in confidence all personal information entrusted to me, and refraining from any actions which may endanger life or health. I will endeavor to keep my professional knowledge and skill at the highest level and to give loyal support and cooperation to all members of the healthcare team. I will do my utmost to honor the International Code of Ethics applied to nursing and to uphold the integrity of the profession. Excuse me. Excuse me, everybody. Our closing class speaker is now Norma Pallison.
Good evening, students, family, friends, and faculty members. For those of whom you do not know me, my name is Norma Pallison. And first of all, I would like to thank all of my classmates for selecting me as one of their speakers. It is a privilege and honor to represent such an amazing group of individuals here today. I didn't know they liked me so much. Well, where to begin? Perhaps in our first day of nursing school when we were all scared, unsure of ourselves and what was ahead. And of course, thinking to ourselves, how are we supposed to take this stack of ATI books to our cars? Hashtag, things just got real. Through this nursing school journey, we have learned so much. One, when every answer seems correct, there's always a more correct one. Two, when in doubt, choose pan and airway, hand washing, potassium, or platelets. Can't go wrong. Three, go with your gut. Do not second guess your first answer. Four, more acronyms than I can possibly remember. For example are ABCs. Airway, breathing, and circulation. CAD, COPD, PAD, you name it, we have it. But perhaps the most important of all would be ADPI, the nursing process. Assessment, diagnosis, planning, implementation, and evaluation. This has been engraved so much in all of us that I find myself ADPIing everyone I see. At the grocery store, at line in Starbucks, I'm just ADPIing everywhere. As my journey began to get inspired and get ideas for this speech, I wanted to touch on every aspect of what it is to go through nursing school, and perhaps this sums it all up. ADPI will forever be with us, so I thought it would be a good idea to incorporate it into our nursing school experience and show off my new acquired nursing lingo. Beginning with A, assessment. This is where we use our assessment skills to collect data, both objective and subjective, to identify problems. Us as nursing students have plenty of those. School is difficult, challenging. Most of the time we lack sleep, we lack physical activity, have poor eating habits, more stress than we can handle or even knew it was possible, and a mental breakdown every now and then. Usually happens right before our clinical day, an exam, or before one of our famous ATI proctor exams. Not the best time when you feel like you can't remember anything. Second, diagnosis. In this step, we take the information we have gathered from the assessment and use our critical thinking skills to analyze information and identify the possible problem. For us as nursing students, it could be stress, social isolation, impaired memory, knowledge deficit, imbalanced nutrition, less than or more than body requirements, all related to nursing school and our passion for nursing, as evidenced by all of us sitting here today in our pinning ceremony, having overcome all those obstacles in the last 2 years. Third, planning. In this step, the nursing process, we establish certain goals, measurable goals. I can say that for all of us, our priority goal was to graduate nursing school. And here we are today. We did it. To get through here, though, was a lot of work, a lot of sleepless nights, and much needed encouragement from many of our professors and family members. I can only imagine that we all set up different goals based on our strengths and weaknesses. Some of us needed more practicing holding those three syringes in one hand at one time. Some of us needed a way to decrease our stress, our anxiety. And some of us needed a little extra push to remember all those lab values. Perhaps some of us are still working on those. But whatever our goal was, We all took different pathways, but that did not matter, as long as we all met each other here at the end, and here we are. Thank you to our families and friends. You will no longer have to hear, sorry, I can't. I'm in nursing school. Fourth step, implementation. Time to take action as we have now identified our goals. No matter our goal, each of us develop our own pathway to reach it. As I mentioned, some may have needed more certain things, maybe more crying time, maybe more or less caffeine, or simply a break, where we slept more than actually 5 hours a night. Some needed an extra one-on-one time on the skills lab, or a little bit one time with our instructors. But the best way that I have found to stay on track with our goals in nursing school was through a great group of friends, the ones behind me dressed in white. Our friends were there to listen to our venting. They gave us that extra little push and encouragement, were there to make us laugh, but most importantly became our family during the nursing school to help us reach the next step, the final step, evaluation, where our actions are now being evaluated, and we look back into our nursing journey to see what has worked. It doesn't matter what path we chose or when we started. What matters is that we are sitting here having completed our profession, one which requires a lot of hard work and dedication. With that being said, we should all be proud of our accomplishments in the last 2 years. Our sacrifices, our dedication, perseverance to make it to the end of our nursing school journey. Each of us has earned every smile, tear, laugh, failure, and most importantly, success. Finally, our priority goal has been met. The COS nursing program has been completed. Lastly, it's been an honor to be part of this graduating class as we continue to work with each other and improve the nursing profession with our knowledge, integrity, respect, compassion, credibility, but most important, our love for nursing. I would like to thank all of our faculty members for sharing with us your time, your knowledge, love, and appreciation. Thank you to Mrs. Kirsten, our director of nursing, for helping us in everything we did. Mr. Morris, it is an honor to have you pinning with us this afternoon. Congratulations, class of spring 2019. We did it.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our program. The graduates will begin their recessional to the front of the theater, and please allow them time to exit completely. Then you can join them out in the front.
It's a celebration.